A very warm afternoon to each one of you. Let us begin with this session on B.Ed. CET mental ability. But before I begin, just a small introduction to my college, Hansraj Jeevandas College of Education. For those who were not there with us last time, Hansraj Jeevandas College of Education, situated in Khar, has been re-accredited with a A-plus grade by NAC. Recognized under 2F and 12B by UGC. It's a Gujarati linguistic minority aided institution. A very old institution established in the year 1969. And we have already completed more than 50 years, you can say. The best part about our college, because of which we have got an A-plus grade, is the excellent staff, the faculty, all qualified staff, very committed, very dedicated, and always working, always alert, always working for the welfare of students. And we have an excellent infrastructure, which I think we cannot, it's like cannot be compared with any other institution. The first B.Ed. college in Mumbai, where digital launch of RUSA projects was done by our Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi. There is one more colleague who's there helping with the initiating this program with us, Dr. Pallavi Talekar. Pallavi madam, are you there?
Yes, Vaishali ma'am, I'm there.
Okay, yeah. Okay, so if you can just come on the video
Yeah.
so that they see, I've just spoken about excellent faculty and one is, Dr. Pallavi Talekar madam is with us. So she's there to help with all the initiation and the beginning of this program. So a big thank you to you, Pallavi madam.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Vaishali ma'am.
Okay, with this small introduction, I think I can say that I welcome you all on behalf of the management of Gujarat Research Society, Hansraj Jeevandas College of Education, our principal, Dr. Anita Swami madam, and all our staff and students. Okay, just before I begin, if you can just switch on your videos so that we can maintain our records, with the photos Pallavi madam would take, so we can maintain a record. So just request you to put on your videos for 2 minutes. Just 2 minutes. I know there would be a bandwidth issue, so maybe you can switch off later. Just put on your videos for 2 minutes and then you may switch off. And hope everyone has named themselves because that becomes better for me to call out. Otherwise, I would have something like galaxies and A30s and all that. So please rename yourself with your proper name. So now let us begin with our mental ability session. And I know all of you are looking forward to this session because I know this the questions based on mental ability, I'm sure would create some sort of mental load on you. And you would like to know the techniques and the tips to solve these questions on mental ability. Okay, before I begin, I'm sorry the recording, last time's recording got delayed due to some technical issue, but I think it would come. We would give you the YouTube link by today or by tomorrow morning for sure. And this recording also would be available to you as soon as possible. Okay, so here I begin. some issue there. Okay. So what are we going to cover in this session? I'm sure you're looking forward to it. Basically, we are going to look at the questions on mental ability, and we're going to understand the techniques of solving. See, it's not that you just have to guess the answers, or just, you know, people who may be used to this type of questions are able to solve it and others are not able to do it. Nothing of that sort. You all can crack these questions if you know the technique of solving this. Understand the technique and practice the technique. Understand and keep practicing more and more such questions. At the end, I'll give you some names of some websites, some links I'll give you where you can find lots of these questions with answers and you can practice. Okay? And in case there is some issue you're not able to understand, then of course, the elimination method, okay, as there is no negative marking. Okay, so already set. Okay, let us move ahead. I think in the last session, I did tell you that B.Ed. CET, Common Entrance Test, has three sections to it. Okay, it has total 100 questions, 100 marks, and you are supposed to solve the CET, complete the CET exam, solve all those 100 questions in a time period of 1 hour 30 minutes or 90 minutes. Okay, so you have 1 hour 30 minutes. So you can tentatively say that you have one complete minute to solve one question. Okay, so in that 1 minute, you have to use certain techniques to solve especially these questions on mental ability. Okay, teacher aptitude are straightforward questions. General knowledge are also straightforward. It's like you know, you give the answer. But mental ability would involve some sort of solving, some sort of graphical organizing the elements, some technique of doing it. Okay, so that would take a little more time. So out of that 90 minutes, you can say that almost you can spend around, 45 minutes. You can almost spend 40 to 45 minutes on mental ability questions. Okay, a little more time on mental ability questions and a little less on teacher aptitude and general knowledge. So last time I had shared with you that mental ability, 40 questions, 40 marks, 1 mark for every question and for every correct answer, and no negative marking for a wrong answer. Teacher aptitude section, 30 questions, 30 marks. General knowledge, 30 questions, 30 marks. Okay, so with this background, let me proceed further. Basically, what are these questions on mental ability? I'm sure some of you have gone through some books and all that. Okay, or you've checked also, since the information brochure is out, some idea you would get about what questions are there. So there are questions based on series, number series, alphabet series. Questions based on classification, analogy, coding and decoding, relationship, direction sense, blood relations, clock and calendar, puzzle test, and problems on dice. So basically the questions are meant to see how alert you are. How can you reason out? How accurately you can think? Okay, how fast you can think? Naturally, how fast you can think, if you practice, you can do things better. So how fast you can think, how accurately. So once you know the reasoning technique, you can reason out those questions. And if you practice, you will naturally be more alert also. Okay, so let us begin our first set of questions. I have purposely kept these questions here because last time also I had given these questions and some of you did not. Okay, a few of you gave me answers, but some of you did not. You kept wondering as to how do we solve them. Okay.
Once again, 36.
Yeah. Why? What is the reason? Quickly.
And 2 to the 4, square. 3 to the 9. And
square of numbers.
Yeah, they are squares of numbers, all consecutive numbers, like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 36 is the answer. So did you see a pattern there? The squares of consecutive numbers beginning from 2. 2 square 4, 3 square 9, 4 square 16, 5 square 25, 6 square 36. So basically, basic, you know, till maybe your 19, 20, you need to know the squares of numbers. Let us go to the next question. Complete the series. Yes, what was the logic last time some of you applied?
Double the number and minus 2.
Okay, you say that double the number and minus 2. So 13, 26, 26 minus 2, 24.
24.
Okay. And
24,
48 minus 2, 46. Okay, 46 double 92 minus 90. 90 would be 180
minus 2.
Okay, so 178 double it multiplied by 2. So you have
three fifty-six.
Achha, 356.
Minus 2, we get 354.
I think there is small error there. Okay, 356, the second one. Okay, fine.
No, 354 minus 2, if we get...
Okay, nah, 356 minus 2, 354 is the correct answer. Yes, you are right. Please, I request all of you to keep a paper and a pencil with you. Because, and please make down, you know, note down the points also. Okay? So, did you see one thing? There is a trend. Okay, there is a pattern there. That you, in the first question, you are trying to find the squares of numbers, consecutive numbers. In the second, there is a pattern. 13 multiplied by 2 minus 2. So, 13 twos are 26 minus 2 would give you 24. 24 multiplied by 2 would give you 48 minus 2, 46. 46 multiplied by 2, 92 minus 2, 90. 90 multiplied by 2, 180, 180 minus 2, 178. Now 178 multiplied by 2, 366. Minus 2 would give you 354. Okay? So basically, what are we supposed to look at? Whenever you get a question on number series, try to see whether they are consecutive odd numbers, even numbers, or prime numbers. What do you mean by odd numbers?
One, three, five, seven, nine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anything that is not divisible by 2. Anything that is not divisible by 2. What is an even number?
2, 4, 6, 8, 9.
Any number that is divisible by 2 is an even number. What is a prime number?
Number that is not divisible.
Number that is not divisible by any other number, but by itself or by 1.
Yeah.
Okay, so which are the prime numbers?
2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29.
Okay, perfect. Yeah. And can you tell me what is a composite number?
Numbers that is divisible by 2.
Yes. And yeah, numbers which are divisible by other numbers. They are products.
Numbers and products.
Yeah. Okay. What about squares and cubes of numbers? We just saw the first question was based on squares of numbers. You may have something which is a square root of numbers also. So you may have, but your squares of numbers, cubes of numbers. What do you mean by cubes of numbers?
Multiplying the number three times.
When the power is 3. Okay, when the power is 3. Like in squares, you have 2 raised to 2. So which is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 is 4. 3 raised to 2, which is 3 multiplied by 3, which is equal to 9. But in cubes of numbers, it is written as 2 raised to 3, which is equal to 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 4 twos are 8. Okay, 2 twos are 4, 4 twos are 8. 3 raised to 3, So what do you mean by 3 raised to 3?
3 cube.
3 into 3.
Okay, 3 cube, which is nothing but 3 into 3, which is 3 threes are 9, 9 threes are 27. So you could have number series of that order also. Next is you have sum. You add the first number and the second number. You multiply with some number, okay? Or you subtract some number. So some of these operations are seen, like what we saw in the second one, that you were multiplying with 2 and you were subtracting 2 from it, okay? So that way, or you, you were adding a sum, you were taking the sum and maybe product of 2 numbers or difference of 2 numbers. And in the fourth one, sorry for that, the fourth one, you would have operations. Add something, subtract something, multiply with something, or divide by some number. So you could have all these patterns in your numbers. Only thing is you need to identify the pattern properly. So once you see the series, rather than becoming jittery, I think just take your paper and pencil. They give you paper, pencil. Just quickly carry your pen with you. They give you papers. So just try solving. What pattern do you see between consecutive numbers? Maybe the first number, second number. Second number, third number. Third number, fourth number. Okay? So look at these numbers for you.
Miss, 240.
What is the answer? 240. You are absolutely right. Tell me, what logic did you use?
Divide by 1, divide by 2.
Okay, 3. Very good. So 240 you divided by 1. Answer was 240. Okay. So between 1 and 2, 240 you divided by 1, you got 240. That was the second number. Then what are you supposed to do next? What pattern did you see? Look at 120 and 40. What do you see there?
Divisible by 3.
Divisible by 3. So 120 divided by 3 would give you 40. 40 divided by 4 would give you 10. 10 divided by 5 would give you 2. So do you see a pattern? So you have to divide the first number by 1, second number by 2. Okay? So first number, if you 240, you divide by 1, you get 240. 240, you divide by 2, you get 120. 120 you divide by 3, you get 40. 40 you divide by 10, you get 10. 10 you divide by 5, you get 2. So the answer is 240. Hope this logic is clear here.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's look at the second question, question number 4. Is there any pattern visible to you?
1 plus 6 is 7, so 13 plus 6 will be 19.
One minute, I did not get it. Yeah, please repeat.
First number, 1 plus 6 is 7. So when you add the number 13 plus 6, you get 19. The number before the...
Okay, fine. That is your logic. Okay, fine. Absolutely fine. Yes, student. Yes, candy participants. 1 and 2. So directly she has the link that 1 and 7. So 2 is just to mislead. 2 does not give you any pattern. Just to mislead. So 1 and 7. 1 plus 6 is giving you 7. Okay. And 13 plus 6 would give you 19. So that is the idea. At times, certain numbers are put in to mislead. They don't have any value. Like 2 and 12 is just to mislead. Okay. It does not have any value or any logic there. Just kept in between. So you have to skip this number, look at the third number. So you can see certain pattern here also. Okay, so this is with number series. Let us move to alphabet series. Okay, that was exclusively number series. And let us come to alphabet series. What I would advise you, whenever you're doing any alphabet series, what happens is there are 26 letters in the alphabet. And it is not possible to visualize all 26 letters. So quickly write down the 26 letters of the alphabet. Okay, write 13 on top and 13 below it. So just quickly write down the alphabets.
E.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. And below that, the next set of alphabet.
Ma'am, the answer is E.
Answer is E, yes. But we are just discussing what logic. So just write the 13 alphabets on top. And below that, you write the next 13 alphabets. Okay? So have you written, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, keep that ready now. Now, as you can see, the first alphabet, the first letter here is Y. So it is from the end. From the end, we have to consider. So that is Y. Okay, just put a underline it or circle it. Next is U. Underline it or circle it. Next is Q. Underline, circle, M, I. What pattern are you seeing between this underlined or circle numbers?
Yes, I'm seeing by three.
How many numbers are there, alphabets you are supposed to?
There is a difference of four letters.
Four. So you circle that number, the alphabet, leave four alphabets, go to the next alphabet. So Y to U. U, leave four alphabets, you get Q. Q, leave four alphabets, you get M. M, leave four alphabets, you get I. I, from I, leave four alphabets, skip. Okay, and then you will come to E. E is the answer. Similarly, now, look at the sixth question. Now, this is a mixed up alphabet series. Please keep yourself on mute. Please request you. Okay?
Ma'am, V is the answer for 6 points.
Okay. But how did you get it?
So from this part, B is the second letter. And from end, the second letter is Y. Okay. Similarly, the third letter from start is C. And from the end, the third letter is X. So on E and V comes fifth. From start and
fine.
Back.
Absolutely fine. So you're taking one letter on from the beginning and one letter from the end, exactly in the same order. So second alphabet from beginning is B. Last, second last alphabet from, is Y. Third alphabet from beginning is C. Third alphabet from the end is X. Fourth alphabet from the beginning is D. Fourth alphabet from the end is W. Fifth alphabet from the beginning is E. And fifth alphabet from the end is B. So that is the logic. Okay. Just a minute. So basically, what are we supposed to see? We are supposed to look at the pattern. There is some pattern in alphabets, just like there is a pattern in the numbers. But with numbers, there would be operations, squares or cubes, even odd numbers, prime numbers. But with letters, there could be a series of single letters. At times, you may even get pairing of letters, groups of letters also, like AZ, BY, CX, So what would be the next? So D, V. D, W, sorry. Or a combination of letters are given. At times, you may have a combination of letters and numbers also. So please look out for the patterns. Okay. And every term, I'm using the word term of the series, forms a pattern with the preceding term and the succeeding term. Okay, so pattern would be some difference of number, some addition of number. It could be any of these things. So please practice this kind of questions. They're very, once you practice, you get the logic behind it, the reasoning behind it, you can keep solving these questions. So let us see some more questions on alphabet series. I have put one dictionary series also, order of dictionary also. You can check out that also. So please look at the seventh question. Your alphabets are there in front of you. So apply your logic. So first is B, second is D. You may put, circle them or underline them. So for every question, use a different idea. Either you are underlining for one question, second question, circle. Third question, put a cross. Okay, use different signs or, you know, for every question. Otherwise, you'll mix up. You need not write the alphabets again and again. Write it once. Okay, and then suppose there are two questions or three questions. If you have the alphabets in front of you, you, for the one question, you circle the alphabets. For second question, underline the alphabets. Third question, put a cross on the alphabet. Yes.
So B, ma'am, the answer is P.
Answer is P.
Yes. Yeah. What was the logic you applied?
Odd numbers, difference.
No. It is one. Skipping two numbers, skipping three numbers.
Three numbers and four numbers and then five numbers.
Yes.
Okay. So between B and D, how many numbers, how many alphabets have you skipped?
One.
C. Between D and G, how many alphabets have you skipped? Okay. Between G and K, how many alphabets?
Three.
And between K and the next alphabet, you are supposed to skip four alphabets. The answer is P. You always verify your answer. Between P and V also, how many alphabets?
Five.
So use your verification method also. Don't feel that, okay, this is just verify it with the next letter also or the next number also. Arrange the following in the order of dictionary.
B is the correct answer.
B is the correct answer. Okay. Tell me the logic. How do you go about it? That's usually how we used to define
order according to which. So first, A comes first. So scandal A comes first. Then afterwards there is scenery. E comes second. Then afterwards there is school. H comes third. And then science. I comes fourth.
Excellent. Very good. So basically, S and C is common. So you don't have to bother about the common letter, the common alphabets. You start from third alphabet. And you can see it is different for all four. In case it was same for two, then you have to go to the fourth alphabet. Then there would be a tie between the sort of tie between the two. And you have to check the fourth alphabet for them. Okay, so that would give you the correct order. Okay, what about the next one?
P.
Yes, what is the order? Tell me what is the logic. You have your alphabets in front of you.
It's skipping by skipping the letters by even numbers, like two, then four, then six.
Okay. Between A and D, two alphabets are skipped. B and C are skipped. Between D and I, there are four alphabets. E, F, G, H. Okay, so 2, 4. So 2 twos are 4. 4, what do you get? Is there any logic? You can either have 2, 4, 6 or you may have 2, 4, 8. Tell me what logic are you applying?
2, 4, 6.
It is 2, 4, 6. Maybe you may not have that letter. Four, alphabet six. Stands for 8. So it is 2, 4, 6. It is P. Okay. So this is with respect to the series. Let us go to classification. This we had done last time. Let us see the logic behind it. 10th question.
Brass was the answer. Brass.
Okay, why you alloy. Say brass is an the alloy. Answer?
It is brass an is alloy. An alloy.
Yeah, brass is an alloy, whereas copper, iron, aluminium are metals. Okay, sorry, they are elements. Elements. This is a basic idea at school level science. There are elements, there are compounds, and there are alloys. Okay. What is the difference between elements and compounds? Anyone? Seventh standard science. What is the difference? Compounds. What is the difference between elements and compounds?
Elements are not.
Compound is a mixture of.
Compound is a mixture of two elements.
Yes. Yes, compounds is a mixture in a definite proportion like brass. Okay, it's an alloy of two metals, whereas copper, iron, aluminium are made up of, they are elements because they are made up of only one, sort of element. Only copper ions are there or only copper atoms are there. Okay, so it is made up, it is in the pure form. It is not mixed with anything else. So copper, iron, aluminium, iron, sodium, calcium, magnesium, all are elements. And brass is an alloy. Okay. So that is the idea behind it. Okay. Oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, and water.
Oxygen.
Water.
Water, why?
Element.
A compound.
Water is a compound. Compound. Those are elements.
Okay, very good, excellent. Okay, so you have to apply logic. You have to use some classification strategy, which is common for others. And then you have to, which is common for all. And from there, you have to pick out which is the odd man out. So your brass is the odd man out because it is a mixture of, it's an alloy. Water is a compound. So it is different from carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, which are elements. Okay. Similarly, choose the option which is least like others in the group. Sharp paper, sharpener, textbook.
Textbook.
Textbook. Because what is the common classification idea?
Stationery.
Pen,
stationery
paper,
items.
Sharpener, yeah,
and textbook
items.
Is a book.
Yes. If you go to any stationery shop, you may not get a textbook, okay? Until and unless it is a bookstore, you'll not get anything of that. But it says stationery shop. So you'll find the stationery like pen, paper, sharpener, but you'll not find a textbook of any particular subject or a book. So you have to apply simple common sense here. Okay, so what do you do? You sort the items into a given group on the basis of certain common quality. All elements, all stationary items. And from that, you have to spot the stranger or the odd one out. Okay? I'll give you more this details of this. Look at this one now. You can have something like numbers also for this. Choose the options which is least like others in the group. B 25, 35, you're saying? 25 and 35, you're telling
yes.
me?
Yes. Other than right. squares and cubes and B is not.
I think please stop that annotations or I'll have to remove you then. Okay. What is it? What is the relation between 9 and 36? Square of 9 is 81. So what is the relation there between 9 and 36?
Yes, square.
It's a square.
Square.
Okay. 9 is a 36. 9 is a square of 3. 36 is a square of 3. 16 is a square of 4. And 64 is the square of
8.
49 is the square of 7.
7.
Square of 7. 343.
It's a cube.
Yes. So basically, they are squares of numbers, whereas 25 and 35 is a very odd combination. So it does not apply here. Okay. Next one. Choose the option which is least like others in the group. Pencil meter, textbook R, milk liter.
Textbook hour.
Yes, you are right. Tell me the logic. Hello.
Pencil you can measure in meter, milk can be measured in liter, and wheat can be measured in kilogram, but textbook cannot be measured in hour.
Yes, participants. Yes. So you said textbook and R is the odd one out. Why do you say so?
Ma'am, because pencil, we can measure it in meter. Milk can be measured in liter. And wheat can be measured in kilogram. But textbook cannot be measured in hour.
Excellent. Very good.
Yes, okay, ma'am. Correct.
Just give me a minute. I'll have to stop people from annotating. Just give me a minute.
Ma'am,
yes,
I have a doubt in 12th question. The logic was the square of it is a square of numbers, right?
So maybe 49... there is some error in that. 343 would be there would be some error in that question. Okay.
2401.
Yeah, there would be some error in that.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, so we are done with classification. So are you clear? So basically try to look out for some commonality between all those options, which will put them in one put it under one class or one category. And one of those options would be different, an odd one out, so that you have to pick out. Look at this analogies.
Hostel is to doctor.
Hostel and doctor, yeah, they match with others.
Museum to curator. Okay, museum is to curator. So what relation do you find between a museum and a curator?
Curator collects artifacts.
Yes, so he's the one who looks, sort of manages that museum, you can say. He's the one who maintains that, manages that museum.
Yes,
by collecting objects, different sets and keeping it. Similarly, hostel is to doctor. Jail is to jailer. Lawyer is to court. Warden is to hospital.
Jail to jailer.
Very good. Jail is to jailer. Now tell me, why not lawyer and court? Hostel and doctors, doctor I can understand. It should have been hospital and doctor. Okay. Warden and hospital also are out of, we can use elimination method and we can eliminate those. But then why not lawyer and court?
Because the thing is mentioned first and then.
One of you answer at a time. Yes, you're right.
The relationship over here is of a caretaker.
Yes.
A caretaker.
Caretaker, yeah. But here, basically, that is the idea. That is the relationship which you're trying to see. But the answer is not lawyer and court, because the lawyer is coming first. If it would have been the other way around, 4 is to lawyer, then it could have been the correct answer. But it is lawyer is first and court is next. Whereas if you see the relation is between museum, the place is coming first. So jail comes first.
Yes.
And the person who manages or takes care of that place is the curator. So here the jailer comes next. And if it would have been court and lawyer, then court is to lawyer. It would have been the correct answer. But the order is reversed. So it is not the correct answer. Look at the second one. Paw is to cat. Hoof is to
horse.
What is the relation?
A horse has a hoof. Elephant, lion, and lamb have paws.
Paws.
Correct.
Okay. Influenza is to... So look at all kinds of relations. They're asking you the terms for places. Who looks after these places, body parts of animals, microorganism and the disease, like influenza is to virus. So typhoid is to
bacteria.
Okay. So influenza is the disease. Virus is the causating agent. Virus causes influenza. So influenza caused by virus, typhoid caused by bacteria. Okay. This is school level science. So that is what I've been telling, that please read up your school level portion. Your school level CBSE board books are available online free. Please refer to that also.
Ma'am, in the 15th one, even lambs have hoops.
Lambs have hoops.
Yes, ma'am. All regurgitating animals have hoops. The ones that eat grass.
Okay, so did you check on the Google?
Yes, ma'am, even on Google.
Okay, maybe a slight, multiple choice questions, there would be a slight error here and there. But we all know since our childhood that hoofs is always horses. So that is the correct idea. But agreed, nowadays with your Google, this you can check always. Maybe some slight error here and there. Look out for the following. So what analogies are you supposed to draw? You can have analogies like countries and capitals. India is to Delhi. USA is to
Washington, D.C.
Washington, D.C.
India is to Delhi. Australia is to
Canberra.
Okay.
Melbourne.
And what about Germany? India is to Delhi. Germany is to
Hamburg.
What is the capital of Germany? Okay, I'm not here to tell you what is right or wrong. I'm just guiding you. So please look out, refer to the correct capital.
Berlin.
Okay, fine. Then country and currency. So I'm not telling that you should know the currency of each and every country. But some important currencies, and many currencies are like common in some countries also. So some important currencies like India, rupees. USA,
dollars.
You can talk about Indonesia. What is it?
Rupaya.
Rupaya, yeah. Okay. Thailand.
Chinese yuan.
Thailand.
Okay. I'm just asking you. Okay. Please check out. Some product difference of numbers. That is what we saw. Squares of numbers. Or there is some relation between the numbers with respect to some or product or difference or even squares and cubes also. So you're supposed to see that. Animals and young ones. Cat is to kitten. Okay. Tiger is to
cub.
Similarly, sounds. Elephant, trumpets. Cat.
Meows.
Okay. Even the movement, there are certain terms used. So accordingly, you can look at that also. So this, you can have a look at this also. Okay, young ones, sounds of animals, movement. So that way also analogies can be drawn. Things and class. Okay, things and class. Like what we saw, pen, paper, sharpener, stationery. Spoons, forks, plates. What is the class?
Crockery.
Okay.
Crockery.
Okay. Soap, shampoo, detergents.
Toiletries.
Toiletries.
Yes. Work, workers and the products. Who's the worker and the product? Okay. So the worker could be electrician, geezer. Similarly, you can have a goldsmith, jewelry item. Okay, something of this sort. Who is the worker and what is the product? Okay, a mill worker, cloth. Okay, the product is cloth, the worker and the cloth, product. Worker and the working place, the one we just saw. Worker is a lawyer, working place is court. Worker is a doctor, working place is hospital. Warden is a worker, working place is hostel. Okay? Words and synonyms. Augment is to increase. Mitigate is to
decrease.
So the words and the synonyms, analogies also you would see. Games and the place. Cricket is to field. Tennis is to?
Court.
Product and material. Okay. Furniture is to wood. Okay. Furniture is to wood. Shirt is to?
Cloth.
Okay, so this kind of analogies. So please be careful, you know, when you're referring to, when you're reading, please read up about countries, capitals, countries, currencies, animals and their young ones, sounds of animals, movements of animals, some particular term is used for movement of animals, things and class, workers and products, workers and the working place, words and synonyms, games and place, product and material. Okay, so let us see some more questions. Skin is to psoriasis. What is the relation? First of all, check the relation. Skin is to psoriasis.
Skin infection.
Yeah, skin. So psoriasis is the skin infection. That infection happens
to
the skin. Skin is the organ to its disease. Okay, organ and its disease. So teeth is to rhinitis. I said, please, I want you to mute yourself. Please don't speak. And, you know, quickly mute yourself after you speak. Teeth is to rhinitis. Rhinitis is to do with your respiratory organs. Blood is to COVID-19.
No.
Eye is to cataract.
Yes.
Yes.
Eye is the organ. Cataract is the disease. Nose is to cavity. No. Okay. Plane is to aluminium. Shoe is to
leather.
So plane is a, you can say it's like a product material. And product. Made up of material aluminium. So shoe is the product made up of material leather. Okay. You can have some other options also, like cloth, rexin. So leather is not there, cloth may be there, or maybe rexin or something may be also. Let us do this coding. So let us code them and decode them. Okay. So sugar is coded as ZNMDB. Okay. So what are you supposed to do is, over here, I would advise you to do something like this. Okay. You write S sugar, U. Okay. And below that, you write Z. N, you complete it. I'm just showing you a small part. N, okay. Write T separately. And below T, what are you supposed to write?
FLD.
FLD.
Is the answer is fourth one.
Answer is fourth one.
Yes. What are they asking you to find? Great. How would you code great? So sugar is coded as ZNM, ZNDB, ZNMDB, and T is coded as FLD. So how would you code great?
So miss, yeah. So from the sugar, the third letter
reference
T
of,
and the reference,
yeah,
of
reference of T and sugar
is to M.
M.
So
yeah,
your letter would be M.
R is to B.
R is to B. Your next letter is B. Okay. I think you need not even go further. If you don't have time, you can stop here. But if you have time, do check all. So the answer is M F D F N. Okay. Similarly, look at this farmer. Now here there is no letter to alphabet coding. It is word to number coding. So write the word farmer, and below farmer you write 562042. And write hot separately, and below that you write 817.
Answer is B.
Answer is B.
Okay, the answer is B. How did you get it? So for M, so you can see for M, the code is 0.
0.
For O, the code is, so like O is the next alphabet. O, the letter is 1. Coding is 1. Then is your T, so 7 is your coding. Then is your H. Where is H? Here. H is to 8. So the answer is here. Is this fine? How do you do coding and decoding? So you code it. Okay. Of course, here it is coding only. So this is the way it is coded. You decode it and again you code it. So the coding sugar is coded. T is coded and you decode it. And then again you code the word great mother or so. Okay, let us see some logic behind it. Okay. So what do we do in coding and decoding? You try to find out common letters in the words. Okay. You try to apply logic and see what common letters are used. Try to find the code for the common letters. So try this kind of way, or the one I showed you also. Write one below the other and try to see for the common letters what is the code used and try and find out. Let us look at this.
You sleep on the bed, so the answer is wall.
Yes. Okay, don't go get confused between all those remaining. It's coding. Bed is called wall. So where will I sleep? I'll sleep in bed, but bed is called wall. Don't go ahead. Wall is called terrace. Don't do that. Just find the simple link here. Similarly, go for the next one. Now it is coding of words and numbers.
Four.
How will you write? Write apples are good. For apples, use 7. R, 4. Good, 3. Similarly, write buy good fruits. Buy good fruits, you write buy 6, good 5, and fruits 7. Okay, so you have got, and the next is 9, 3, 4. So below that, you write 9 apples, 9 R, 3 red, 4. So which digit means red? So you have to see which is the common one. Where does red appear? Apples
9
are good. Apples are red. So the answer is
9, 3, 4.
4 or 9?
9.
4.
The answer is 4. It's very clear cut, you know. 4 is the answer. So the code is letter number 4 for red. Okay, let us go to blood relations now. How do we understand this blood relations? Okay. Now see here, a person standing there, a lady, there is a lady. Now for lady, you can have, whenever you give male, female, there's a lady, okay? You can call the lady as A or you, whatever, A, and you have to put a circle. So lady, so put it's a circle. Sister. If it's a man, put a box. So a lady said, the person standing there is my, so there is one person standing here, is my grandfather's only son's daughter. So this again is a lady. This person is a lady. So I'm putting a circle. So she says that person standing there is my grandfather's only son's daughter. My grandfather's. So you have to go. Yes. Okay. Your grandfather. My grandfather. Okay. Double. This is your father. This is grandfather. Okay. My grandfather's only son. So grandfather's only son. So that is my father. That is my father. And naturally, this P is the daughter of S. So naturally, they both are. How is the lady related to the standing person?
Sister.
Okay. I'll give you the symbols for writing all this. So I used a proper symbol. So there is no chance for you to go wrong. Okay. So no chance of you to go wrong if you use the right symbols. So if there is a male, you use a square box. If it's a female, use a round circle. And if it is grandparents, put that at second level. Parents at the first level. And siblings at the same level. Okay. And if it is the only child, okay, just put one line like this. Okay, look at this one. A and B are brothers. So let us write A and Uncle. B are brothers. So how will you show the relation? A and B both are men. Okay, they are males. So we put a square box. They both are brothers. So they are siblings. There's a relation between them. C and D are sisters. Okay. A's son is D's brother. How is B related to C?
Uncle.
Okay, uncle. So A's son is D's brother. A's son. So I don't know. Actually, I know that it is a son and it's a boy. A's son is B's brother. So I'll put it this way. Is B's brother. Okay. How is B related to C? And C and D are sisters. So naturally, what do you understand about C and D's genders?
Female.
Female.
And they are at the same level. So they are siblings. A and C are brothers. So how is B related to C?
Uncle.
Okay. Clear?
Uncle could be father also, ma'am.
No. Oh, no. Because S, D, C, all are siblings. They're real brother sisters. They're not cousins. They're all brother sisters. As you can read from this information, they all are brothers and sisters. And B is A's brother. So how is C B related to C? Uncle answer is uncle.
Ma'am, what is the answer of 23 question?
Sister, we decide.
Okay. Thank you.
We arrived at sister. No? Okay, fine. Just move ahead. I think I'm using that annotation, so that is why I'm getting stuck again and again. Okay, let us try some blood relationship questions. This is done. Let us come here. So this is what I was telling you. Suppose you should know all relations. father's or mother's son, okay, they would be brothers. Father's son, mother's son means they are brothers. Father's daughter, mother's daughter would be sisters. Mother's or father's brother. Sorry, I'm sorry for that. When you say that your mother's or father's son, your mother's or father's son, what is that person? How is that person related to you?
That person is your brother.
Yes. Your father's or mother's daughter, how is that person related to you?
That person is your sister.
My sister.
Yes. Sister. Your father's or mother's brother, how is that person related to you?
That person is your uncle.
Okay. Very good. Father's, mother's sister, how is that person related to you?
She's my aunt.
Aunt, auntie. Okay. Mother's or father's father? Mother's father or father's father?
Grandfather.
Grandfather.
Mother's or mother's mother or father's mother?
Grandmother.
Oh, that's a mistake. There's grandmother. Grandmother would be the correct one. Son's wife. So your son's wife is your daughter-in-law. Your daughter's husband is your son-in-law. Your husband or wife's sister. So your husband's sister is your sister-in-law. Your wife's sister is your sister-in-law. Okay. Your husband's brother is your brother-in-law. Your wife's brother is your brother-in-law. Your brother's son is your nephew. Your brother's daughter is your niece. Your uncle's or aunt's son. Your uncle's or aunt's son or daughter is your cousin.
Brother or sister. Huh? Cousin.
Sister's husband. Your sister's husband is your brother-in-law. And your brother's wife is your sister-in-law. Okay, I was just talking about the different symbols. So whenever you get information, what you have to do is when you are doing some questions based on relationships, blood relations, just put the right information. Read one info at a time. One idea at a time and put the graphical symbols. Like if you know that's a male, put a box. Female, put a circle. If you're not able to identify whether D was a boy or a girl, then don't put any symbol. Wait till then. Okay? A and B are married to each other, so A is equal to B. A and B are siblings. Remember, I used to put an arrow indicating the relation. A and C are B's children. So I had told you that put the children at a lower level and B at an upper level. The parents at the upper level, grandparents at the second level. Only child is the single arrow going downward. Only child. And uncle or aunt is again, like how you write for your siblings. So A and B are brothers. So A and B are using that double-sided arrow. And A's only child could be C. That is the indication. Okay, please make a note of this. So of course, I'll share the recording with you, but please make a note of this. Okay. Doesn't it become easy when you try using the symbols and try solving? I don't think you'll make any mistakes if you try to use this proper idea and you know the relationships. Relationships, if you know them. Okay. Can I move ahead? Done? Have you made a note of the same? Okay. Okay. Some more ideas. Remember, you can even draw. If it's a complicated relation, you may draw a family tree, like the one we were drawing. Identify the male and the female, first of all. Put each member in their respective positions. Remember, I told you a tree. So father or aunt, uncle would be at a higher level. Grandfather, grandmother would be still at the second level. So put the proper positions in the tree, put the symbols as indicated earlier. So male, female, or whatever, symbols, the arrows, only child, siblings, all those arrows, you uncle, aunt, you put properly. You will get to see the relationship. Let us try and solve some more questions. Please try this too. you try using the graphical symbols. So graphical symbols and the relationship names that we give. We saw. Read each information, each piece of information carefully, put it properly.
Question number 25, sister.
Mother.
Mother.
Yes. Could you get it very quickly using the right symbols and the
indications? Ma'am.
Very good. The answer is mother. Is there anyone who's not getting it?
Question number 6, answer is B, brother.
26, you mean to say?
Yeah, ma'am, 26. A, brother.
Okay. You got it very quickly. Very soon you got the answer. Did you use the proper symbols the way I explained to you? Anyone else? 25th and 26th?
26th, father-in-law.
Actually, you're getting father-in-law. Let me check. I'm not aware of the answer. I'll also check.
Brother.
Father. Not brother. It is wrong. Brother is a wrong.
It's father-in-law.
Father-in-law. It's
father-in-law. Check it properly. Do not be in a hurry.
Yeah, yeah.
Practice.
Yeah,
ma'am. Have a speed related to it. It's father-in-law. Hope you all got the 25th answer also. I think if you use this basic graphical, this ideas, you can do it very soon and you can do it accurately. Yes, 25th is clear.
Yes.
Answer is mother. That only daughter, son. So, you know, when it is only daughter or only son, you know, you have to draw on a downward arrow with the arrowhead going, pointing in the downward direction. Yes. Should I move ahead?
The answer of 26 is father-in-law.
26 is father-in-law. Yeah, you're right. It's not brother, it is father-in-law. You draw the entire family tree, you will come to know the answer. Take one piece of information at a time. Do not read everything together. Okay, maybe you want to give one glance, you do it, but go pointing to a man. So somebody is pointing to a man. Okay, A is the wife of B. So write it properly. A, female, B is a man. And what do you put? Arrow equal to sign. Now B is the brother of Z. So you put that sibling sign. Z is the son of P. So you put P at upper level because P is the father of Z. So naturally, P is not at the same generation as A, B, and Z. P is at a upper, you know, one generation prior. Okay, so how is P related to the father-in-law? Okay, I hope you've got it. Do you need any explanation here? Can I proceed further?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, this is something very interesting, the puzzle test. Okay. Now, whenever you're using the puzzle test, you may have to draw tables, you may have to draw circles or squares. Okay. So, let us understand this. If you see that there are some males, females here, and there is a So let us try drawing this. There are four people and they're sitting around. 1 minute. Annotate. There are four people and they're sitting around a table. Okay. So A is a...
Exam khatam ho gaya na. Abhi bacha hua worksheet jo nahi padha hai, wo padho.
I think you're doing two tasks at a time. Some children monitoring is also going on. So please keep your mic mute. A, Mr. A, So you can put a box like this. He's a man. It's opposite to a cook. So male, female, I'm putting in the first level. And cook, I am writing on the second level. So here is my cook. Okay. Then Miss B sits right to the barber. Okay, I'm not getting this idea where Mr. B and barber, I don't know. Washerman is on the left of the tailor and Miss D sits opposite to Mr. C. So Miss C, let me try working this out. Miss D. So let's say my Miss D is here and she is a woman, a female. So I'm putting a circle. She sits opposite to C. So let's say because C sits opposite to D sits opposite to C. No one can sit, none of these two people can sit opposite to A. D sits opposite to C and A, actually the next person would be B. Okay, and B is a female again here. Okay, I've drawn this much. Now Miss B sits right to the barber. So you know right and left, try to use your own right and left. So B sits right to the barber. So B is sitting right to the barber. So for D is the barber. Okay, I'm taking here.
D is the left answer.
Please read slowly. D is the barber. Okay, washerman is on the left side of the. B sits right to the barber. B sits right to the barber. So D is a barber.
Ma'am, the answer is D.
No, B is the cook, no.
B is the cook. B is the barber.
C is the washerman. And A is the tailor.
Washerman is on the left of the tailor. Now I have not got who is the tailor here. One more thing. Look at here, it is washerman. Washerman is a male. So now this C, I've not got this information right now, but let's say on the right of the tailor. So washerman could be A now. Either A or C.
Ma'am, washerman is on the left of the tailor. So the washerman will be C.
Washerman would be C. And what would be A then?
Taylor. So the answer
yes.
Is B.
Yes.
Taylor.
Yes, you're right. Yeah, just give me a minute. Okay. Yes. So see, the washerman is on the left of the tailor. So if you see, washerman is on the left of the tailor. Now we do not know the profession of two people, A and C. So they would be either washerman or the tailor. It is clearly written, washerman is on the left of the tailor.
There is a lot of disturbance.
Rupali, can you please?
Yes, please, everybody. You only identify who is it because I am busy with this.
Miss, it's Rupali.
Please, Rupali, please, please, better not answer if you're busy teaching your kids also or giving them instructions. We can easily hear what you're telling to your kids. The washerman is on the left of the tailor. So if you take the left side, okay, the left washerman is on the left of the tailor. So naturally, washerman is on the left side of the tailor. So A is the tailor and C is the washerman. What are the trades of A and B? A and B. Washerman and the okay.
Taylor and cook.
Taylor and cook.
These.
Okay, fine. So basically for puzzle test, you will have to take in one piece of information, draw, understand, see the male, female, see the profession. So male, female, I have put at one level and the professions I have put at the second level. Okay, let us move ahead. Let us see what logic we apply here. Again, I've got a little stuck up. Okay, look at this. Go step by step as per the instructions given in the puzzle. So take one piece of information at a time. To avoid confusion, use symbols for persons. Okay, like what we saw, square and circles, items by dot, line. Okay, like table, we drew by a line. So use that kind of indication. Sitting in a circle, so it was written sitting around, so you can draw a circle, square if it is square mentioned. And complicated information can be summarized in the form of a table. So let us see how do we manage complicated information. Read this information carefully. And please draw a table because it is not complicated information. So see, I have drawn a table. So now draw a table first of all. So draw this on a shelf. Quickly read through the entire information. I kept 6 books. The 6 books are labeled as A, B, C, D, E, F. Some have green covers, some have yellow colors covers, some are new books, some are old books, some are science books, and some are education books. Okay, so what we have done, we have put the information in the form of a table. A, B, C, D, F are the books. The next is green cover, yellow cover, new book, old book, science book, education book.
Ma'am, just a question. Sorry to interrupt. Over here, it can be other way around also. No? The colors can come on the
anything,
left.
Anything. Absolutely fine. Please go ahead. That is not very important. You can take it anyway. Okay. Okay. Now let us see the information. On a shelf are kept 6 books side by side labeled. So all the 6 books have come. Now B, C, E, F. B has a green cover. So I have put some circle or some, you know, hashtag here. B, C, E, F have green color and others have yellow color. So what is others? A, okay, A and D are the yellow covers. ADB, A, D, B are new books while others are old. So whatever is remaining, C, E, F are old books. Again, A, B, C are science books. And others are education books. Okay. So all my information is arranged in the form of a table. See the logic behind it. Now, which 2 books are old education books and have green covers?
E-F.
E-F.
Which one?
E-F.
E-F.
1 minute. Which 2 books are old education books?
E-N-F.
ENF,
ma'am. Old education books, E and F, and they have green covers. So the answer is ENF. See how simple the things become when you put it in a form of a table. Okay. Now, this is one more. This kind of puzzle tests are very commonly asked in the B.Ed. CET exams. So please practice a lot of puzzle tests. At times, what they do is they give you one puzzle, and there are 5-6 questions based on that puzzle also. So one puzzle or one piece of information, if you draw properly, all 4-5 questions you can answer very easily. So that is the idea in B.Ed. CET questions. There is a group of 5 persons, A, B, C, D, E. So you please draw. Again, you can prepare a table here. Please prepare a table. How will you prepare this? How will you do this? So you can write A here, B here, C, B and E. Okay?
Ma'am, C. Ma'am, C. First one is C.
And A, B, C are intelligent. So intelligent, intelligent, intelligent. Write intelligent on top and then you can put an indication. A is intelligent. B is intelligent. C is intelligent. Hardworking, next. Okay, next is hardworking. I'm putting H. Who's hardworking? So A is hardworking, T is hardworking, and E is hardworking. Next is honest. So let me put H, O, honest. Okay, C is honest, B is honest, E is honest. Ambitious, A. A is ambitious, B is ambitious, and E is ambitious. So who is neither hardworking nor ambitious?
The answer is C.
C is neither hardworking nor ambitious. And which of the following persons is neither honest nor hardworking?
B.
But is
B.
ambitious?
B.
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 Okay. B, clear, no?
B.
Yes, ma'am, B.
B, B.
So here is your, I think some more. You can similarly try solving some more. Look at this. Usually for such puzzle tests, there are 4 to 5 questions based on the same puzzle. I have asked only one question, but usually there are 5-6 questions asked on one puzzle. So please practice this now. I'll give you some time, 30th and 31st. Please draw tables. Okay. Like for fifth, sitting in a row such that. Okay. For this, you can draw one line, one row. Okay. But for 31st, you can put it in the form of a table. Use your logic now. You can take a screenshot of this and try solving and then put the answer on the WhatsApp group, because I think it will take some time. Yes, take a
why?
Screenshot yes. of this.
Why is the
you
answer?
Got the answer so quickly? Why? Okay, you may make a note. You can check the answers later. Just take a screenshot and keep that answer why. And what about 31st? May take some time. Huh? If you apply logic, it will be, you can solve it, but it would take some time. Can we proceed further? Take a screenshot of this and you know, just take a photo from your mobile and keep it with you. Try solving it later. Okay, because we have some more different categories also. Okay. Then comes your direction test. Okay, whenever you're doing any direction questions, please remember that whenever you have direction, remember the map of India. You have your Jammu Kashmir to the north. South is your Kerala, Tamil Nadu. Gujarat is to your west. And eastern, all your Assam and all is at east. Always draw this. And then take the starting position. Always take the starting position from the center. Until and unless not specified. Always start from the center.
So you ma'am, question number 32. North. The answer is C, east.
Okay, let's see. Where? Okay, fine. Yes, you are right. You go to north, then turn right. Okay, as if you are walking. Turn right. And then turn right again. As if you are walking. Huh? You have turned right and you... And then turn to your left. So just visualize, imagine it's you. To your left is east. In which direction are you now? East. Okay? Yes? Fine, easy.
Did he west?
West
now.
What?
No, I think it's east.
It is east only.
East.
Remember this direction chart. Remember the map of India is the direction chart. North, south, west, east. Gujarat is west. Assam and all is east. A farmer travels 20 kilometers north from his house. So we always take his house at the center. Walk 20 kilometers north. So you put the information properly. 20 here. And then turns east. and walks 6 kilometers. And from there, he again turns south and walks 12 kilometers. So this is...
Ma'am, the answer is 8 kilometers. 6, 7,
okay.
10.
Okay. And answer walks 12 kilometers. How far is he from his original position? So you need to know this distance, this. How will you come to know this distance? You have to use your Pythagoras theorem. How much would be this? This would be 6. This is the remaining.
Yeah, this would be 8.
And this would be 10. Your Pythagorean triplet. 6 square, 36. 8 square, 64. 36 plus 64, 100. 100 square root, 10. 10 is the answer.
I have a question. Sorry, ma'am. I have a question. Ma'am, how did you get 8 below 20?
Yeah. See, the total distance, this is 20 as given here.
Huh.
Okay. And then it is written that he walked 12 kilometers down south.
Okay.
So this is 12. So the remaining distance here is 8. See, this is 12, so this would be 12. And the remaining distance of this would be 8. Not able to get it?
Ma'am, because what logically, I might be wrong, but logically what I understand, it is 12 plus 8 will give me 20. So 8 should come on the 12 side, no? So the line of 12 should be extended, no? Why the line of 20 is extended?
One minute. What is the question? Here is his final position. So how far is he from his house? So this is the question. This is okay. What you need to know. Okay. So be clear. Read the piece of information very carefully. Keep yourself very calm and composed or else you'll end up making mistakes. Okay. Let's go ahead. Okay, so direction sense, we just saw. What are you supposed to do? You're supposed to draw a chart, mark the starting point, move along the directions, and if measures are given, write the measures as you move. Okay, you can try this too also. I think you can try it now. Or do you want to try it later?
Later.
These are easier as compared to the puzzle test, so you can take this. Four of you playing cards. You know, how do you sit? And ma'am, partners sit on the opposite side. Your partners playing cards. You sit on the opposite side.
Answer is H.
Yes. What about others?
H.
H. Okay. Two people have got H. So it must be that is the answer. Please check. It's very easy, not difficult. H. What about 35th?
West, H. Ma'am.
It's west.
Answer is west. Okay. Please make a note of it and please try solving. Okay. Let us come to the clock and calendar. Remember last time somebody said that for this, the answer would be 24. Why not 24 and why 22? So in a day, okay, in a day. So there is a day of 12 hours. There is a night of 12 hours. In 12 hours day, okay, in 12 hours day, like let's say between, let's begin like at 12 o'clock. Okay, 12 o'clock midnight. Let's say we are talking about the day, 12 o'clock midnight. We say that the hands coincide. So you consider that as one. So between 12 and 1, it is already coincided. So 12, between 1 and 2, it is coinciding again. 2 and 3, it is coinciding again. 3 and 4 again. 4 and 5 again. 5 and 6 again. 6 and 7 again. 7, 8, 8 again. 8 and 9 again. 9 and 10 again. 10 to 11 again. Okay, so that way it comes only 11 times. In 1, 12 hours, this day or night, it coincides 11 times and not 12 times. So keep this logic in your mind. So in a day, how many times in a day, the two hands of a clock coincide. So in an entire day, when I say day, it is 24 hours. So in 24 hours, it would coincide 22 times. In 12 hours, 11 times. And in 24 hours, which represents a day, it would coincide 22 times. Okay. If the first day of the month having 31st days is a Sunday, what is the day on the 31st of that month? So you
Tuesday.
Can...
Tuesday.
Okay.
Tuesday.
Yeah. So let us see this also. So as you can see, quickly draw a calendar. Just write how you write alphabets. Please write your calendar quickly. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. You can start writing it that way. So the first day it is written that first day of the month having 31 days is a Sunday. So S Sunday. So if you know one Sunday, Saturday is 7th, next Saturday 14th, you don't have to write all numbers. Huh? Next would be 21, next is 28. And quickly you can find out 31st is a Tuesday. Besides that, remember odd days, number of days more than complete weeks. Whenever it is 31, it is more than complete weeks. If it is a leap year, it is divisible by 4. And if it is an ordinary year, not a leap year, it has 365 days. Just remember these basic ideas. Okay, let us come to the clock part. If you look at a clock, the entire circumference is divided into 60 equal parts called as minute spaces. The clock has two hands. One is short and one is long. Short hand is the hour hand. Long hand is the minute hand. And in 1 hour, both hands coincide once. 1 hour once. The two hands are in the same straight line, coincide. So at times, the two hands are in the same straight line. They can be opposite to each other, like 6 o'clock, or coincide like 6:30. Two hands are at right angles, means 15 minutes apart, and are at opposite direction, means 30 minutes apart. Hands coincide 11 times in 12 hours, as common position is 12. That is the reason. And 1 minute space is equal to 360 by 60. So 1 minute space is equivalent to 6 degrees. Okay, so this is some basic idea about clock, and this is the idea about calendar questions. Okay. Okay, some more questions. How many times in a day the hands of a clock will be at right angle?
22.
Again, do remember the common position and keep that in mind. If you're doing this, how many times in a day? Day has 24 hours. So how many times it will be at that right angle position? So that you will have to identify. You can discuss the answers on the WhatsApp group. From the following options, which year is not a leap year? How do you get a leap year?
B, 700.
Yeah, because a leap year is not divisible by?
Divide.
You cannot divide it by?
4.
4.
Okay, look at this through a mirror. I see the time as 8:20. What is the actual time in the clock?
8:40.
Yes. Okay.
4:20.
Please think about it. Please do think about it. Let us move ahead. Some issue here. So I think the same this has come up. Okay, let us see the problems on dais. I would just advise you one thing. Do not be scared of the problems on dais. Very easily you can do it. Always whenever you draw a dais, dais is when you play Ludo and games like that, you have that dais which has 6 numbers. So how many faces does a dais have?
6.
So whenever you have to do any questions on dais, please draw a dais having six faces like this. So I will draw it this way. This side. And this is what I cannot see. I will put it here like this. And this. So this, I have a dais with six faces, assuming that it is a 3D dais.
Okay? Ma'am, the answer is 3.
Yeah, the answer is 3. Yeah, you are right. But I'm just telling you the logic. You are right. So let's say now this is 3. Whenever you are writing the number on the face, let's say this particular face. Okay, this particular face. Please put it somewhere. Okay? Here. So this face is 3. Exactly center. 6. Then where comes 2? 2 comes here. So that I will write here. 2. 1 comes here. Where will 6 and 5 go?
5 is beneath 1.
Opposite 1
is 6. And opposite 2 is 5.
Okay, it's your 5. And where is 6? 6 is on this side. So naturally, what is left here is 4. Which number is opposite to 4 is 3. Okay? Use your proper pen, pencil and try drawing a figure like that. If you apply proper logic and understand. See, 3 on top is 2. 1 is on the left side. So what would be on the right side of 3? Plan it out that way. The answer is 3. Okay? I will go to one more last question and I'll stop here. You can take the last question and then stop. Now this dice has points. Some dice have numbers, some dice have points. Please try this the way I had shown you to draw. Draw and see what is the answer. Anyone?
Which point would be on the opposite?
Somebody got the answer?
5 points?
5. How can it be 5 points? Look at this figure. Here it is 2.
Is it six?
It cannot be. See, 2 is here. So opposite to 2 means down here. How your 5 is coming here? How can 5 be the answer?
6.
6 is the answer. You're right? Please practice this and get it. And the last. I'll give you some links. So that was the last part that we had to cover. So here there are some links. You can note this. IndiaBix.com. And in IndiaBix.com, you'll find all reasoning questions based on this dice. Other things also. Series. Everything is there. So under IndiaBix.com, you'll find verbal reasoning. And in verbal reasoning, you'll have problems on dice. You'll have many problems with answers. Similarly, you can go to Byju's, government exams, logical reasoning. You'll find all these questions to practice. At the same time, in IndiaBix and Byju's, you will get questions related to general knowledge also. Okay, you will get questions related to general knowledge also. So your general knowledge, because I will not be conducting any session on general knowledge that I have told you last time. You can read up your books, read up about countries, India's freedom struggle. So please go through all your CBSE textbooks of history, science, social science and all that. So you'll get the idea of general knowledge, because general knowledge, all UN, international, national bodies, all that is asked. So please, you can check on both these links, IndiaBix as well as Byju's. You will find questions related to mental ability, a lot of different types of questions related to mental ability, and of course, general knowledge also. Okay, please take a screenshot. Otherwise, I'm surely going to send the recording to you. But I'll take my next week, Monday to Tuesday, I'll send you the recording. Last time there was some technical issue. The recording got saved on my computer and then it became a very heavy file for me to send, because there is a, you know, our staff takes care, the staff takes care of uploading on the YouTube. So that took some time. This time this is directly recorded on cloud. So that is not an issue. Okay. So I completed. Do we get maths questions like solving? No. Solving some algebra or theory and all, you don't get usually. Simple ones you will get. Like that number series where addition, subtraction, squares, cubes are there. You'll actually never get a big sum and all to solve and all. That usually does not happen. Because there are no only maths, students of different subjects come to give this exams. Okay. So fine. Any queries to ask? Or else I'll stop. Yes. Mayurika Das. Please send me, I'll send you my mobile number. Please send me a WhatsApp message. Okay, I'll send you the link to join the group. 07. I'll send you the link to join the group. Okay, you get 40 questions on mental ability, 40 marks out of 100 marks of CET. 40 marks for mental ability, 30 marks for teacher aptitude, and 30 marks for general knowledge. And mental ability and general knowledge, you can always do from the links I have provided you. Or even the books, whatever books, which has answers. So now you understand, without answers, it is so difficult to understand which is the correct option. Anything else? Analogy, we have diagrams. So how can we solve this sum? Analogy, we have diagrams. So how can we solve this sums? It is again analogy which involves diagrams. So that you see in the book. Recorded meeting, you'll be able to see, but give me some time. Any questions? Can we prepare for CET without buying, referring the online PDFs and materials? Yes, you can. You can, without buying books, you can refer. I'm going to conduct one more session on teacher aptitude, and I'm going to conduct a session on, not me, the other colleagues are going to conduct a session on ELCT also. So please look out, next week or so, we will have one more session. And after that also, we would have one more session. You can expect a session on teacher aptitude and a session on ELC from us. Ma'am, whatever data that we enter now in the application form can be edited. Your marks, you can edit at the time of option form. But if you do not remember, let me tell you, your admission would get rejected. And religion and all, maybe you can check. That they allow later. So please do not make any mistakes while filling up the application form, especially with respect to your quota, your marks. Please do not make any mistakes.
Ma'am, in the last meeting, you told that you will give us some performa or something for a Gujarati linguistic document to be presented or something.
You don't need it right now. I'll give you things at the right moment. Okay. You don't need it right now. So unnecessary, you all are going asking, give me as the list of colleges. Do you need it now?
If it's required to be signed or something by somewhere.
No, don't worry. Not needed anything. Wait, relax. I'll give you at the right moment. If I give it between, you know, there are people who don't refer to it and then again ask me, where is
it? Yeah, thank you.
I think I should give it to you at the right moment. Which are the aided colleges, I'll tell you at the right minute. Okay. Anything else, or should I end the meeting? Any queries you want to ask? Yes. Okay, I've already got the link. The link is ready. I'm sending it to you. The last session's recording, I'm sending it to you.
Ma'am,
yeah.
ma'am, so I just have a basic question for understanding related to admission process, that suppose if I fall in minority category and there is
fall in minority category means you don't fall over.
Means I fall in the minority quota.
Which quota?
The minority. Like a Gujarati Jain quota, I fall in minority. So suppose
mother tongue is Gujarati, no?
Yes, mother tongue is Gujarati. And I'm a Jain. Now suppose if there is a college which has a Sindhi quota. Suppose if there's a college which has Sindhi quota, then after Sindhi quota, the minority, they'll consider the minority and then the open category.
50% seats. So there are 50 seats. Out of 50 seats, 25 seats for minority quota and 25 seats for the open quota.
Okay.
So yes. They have 50 seats, 25 for Sindhi minority and 25 for the open. Goes that. Okay. Ma'am, any specific book for referring? You may try. You can Arihant, Upkar, whichever has answers at the back, you can refer to those books. Plus, don't rely on those books also. Please do practice from the links and all I have provided also. Anything else? Please practice to get good marks. Otherwise, with less marks, you'll be struggling to get admission in a good college. Exam, see, the form filling has started. It will go on. They will extend the dates. It will go on. So, hope maybe by August end or September, you can expect to have your exams. Anything else? Anything else? Do you have questions or I'll stop here?
Ma'am, after this application form is filled, is there any other form? Like there is going to be another form detect
that would be
the
later.
Exam?
See, now you filled up the application form. You will give your CET exam. You'll get your admit card. You will give your CET exams. After CET exams, after a few days, your results would be out. After your results are out, after that, they will declare the date for filling up the option form. Okay? So if you've made mistakes in filling up the marks or anything, you can rectify it there and you have to fill up the option form. You have to give the preference of your colleges.
Okay.
So you have to. This process would go
and
on
about
now.
All
and
the,
everything you will get in the login and the WhatsApp group, you'll get all kind of information. Yes.
Okay.
Anything else?
No.
I have sent the last time's recording also on YouTube. Please refer to that.
And ma'am, one more thing. For the first four semesters, we got the grade. And for the last two semesters and degree, we got the percentage-wise. So what should we do while entering the marks?
You know what? There are two things. One is you have marks. Even if you have got grades at the end, you have marks for different subjects.
Yeah.
Course-wise, you must be having marks, no? Add up all those marks, semester 1, semester 2, semester 3, add all that. And then accordingly, you divide by the 6. You will get your average percentage and convert it into percentage. Otherwise, if you're planning to do your CGPA conversion, then you will have to go to your college, get the conversion from there. You don't need to upload it right now, but you have to get the right conversion and then only enter it. And you should have a proof of that. Without that, better not convert. So better is you add up all your individual marks, okay, all totaling for every semester and divide it by 6. And
so in my six semesters grade now, we also got the overall percentage of the degree and we also have this grade A, B and C types. And also the CGPA and everything is mentioned on the last sem, six sems grade mark. So what should we do while entering? Should we go for the conversion thing? Or is it okay if we enter by the overall percentage given?
I have told you, if you've got the overall percentage given, you can enter the overall percentage. Rather, if you're going for CGPA, some colleges convert it in a different way. So if you try to convert, you may go make a mistake. And they do not like mistakes. You know, even if there is a mistake of point something, they don't accept it. So be very precise when you're adding your marks.
Okay.
Let Mama. There not be another answer to it. Okay? Not another percentage number to it. Yes.
Ma'am, I have applied for my conversion, from the college. But it's taking some time. So I wanted to ask, the CET exam, do they have like a certain number of students that they will take in? or it will stop as soon as the seats are full, something like that.
No. This will go on till 27th is July's last day. Try to filling up. There's a confusion. In the form, it is written 27 July and the schedule, it is written 26. So 27 July, short after that also days are extended at times. But don't take the risk of extension and all that. See, somebody has written, my overall percentage is not matching with CGPA. It will not match. So you decide what do you want to enter. CGPA conversion has to be from the college. And then only you enter. You don't do any conversions. And overall percentage, you can also do. But be very precise in doing that conversion calculation. Okay. Add all marks, all 6M marks, divided by the, convert it into out of 100 percentage. Divided by 6 and do all those proper conversions. Ma'am, anything else?
Ma'am, just a doubt. What is to be done for credits earned C and credit grade points G? Nothing, no?
Nothing.
All right. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Should I end the meeting?
Ma'am?
Huh?
In my, all my semesters are out of 800. So even if I remove my average and I put it in the marks obtained, what am I supposed to put in the marks out of thing?
Total marks, overall marks, all 6 semesters are total. So 800 plus 800 plus 800 plus 800, okay, 6 okay. times. So that way it will go.
Okay. Thank you.
For BCom and all, it is total is 4,000, no? Out of that, how much? For BSc, it is 5,000 something, 400 or something. Okay? So marks obtained that way and convert it to percentage. Yes, fine. Be very precise in calculating the percentage. No mistakes tolerated. Huh? Don't say that, I made a mistake while doing the calculation and all. Do precise calculation. Okay, I'm stopping the meeting here.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye.
Thank you.